These major operations are usually too expensive for ordinary people to pay for. This is why the annual neurosurgical camp is popular among patients who get these life-saving surgeries for free. This year, over 700 lucky patients have been treated in the 2 weeks medical camp, undergoing operations for brain and spinal tumors.
On Monday, we had 6 cases. On Tuesday, we also had 6 cases. Wednesday, 4 cases. Thursday, 3. And Friday, there were 2. So altogether, that's so far around 21 cases so far last week. Now, someone asked the question, why brain tumors? We don't know why brain tumors. Nobody knows the cause. Although they say sometimes it runs in families. So the answer is not there, it's not clear. Any other questions?
What is your target?
Our target actually was 50 to 60 patients.
How much does it cost to operate with brain tumors?
The case in a private setting, you are talking close to 30 million and above for surgery for a brain tumor.
Dr. Michael Edigam Humuza, a neurosurgeon at Mulago Hospital, explains that the operation for each patient takes between 8 to 9 hours. Humuza says since last week, over 21 cases have been worked on at no cost. Some of them have been discharged. Mulago Hospital currently has 6 neurosurgeons and about 20 neurosurgeries.
There are so many cases. And that's why I say we book them. The extent is great, and of late it's even more clearer because people are more aware, and we do have diagnostic services even in upcountry places. Like in the east, we have some CT scan in around Chua and Mbale. In the west, we have in Mbarara, I think Masaka and Kabale. And I think also in the north. So when these CT scans are more, patients and the doctors are able to diagnose, the patients much earlier.
So on a monthly basis, how many patients such can you receive at Mulago?
With neurosurgery patients undergoing diagnosis and surgical treatment of disorders of the central and peripheral nervous system, including congenital anomalies, trauma, tumor, vascular disorders, infections of the brain or spine, and stroke, among others. Meanwhile, the acting director of Mulago National Referral Hospital, Rosemary Byanyima, confirmed that nurses who have been on strike since May 26th are now back at work. She noted that the absence of nurses affects the hospital's operations.
We also put mechanisms in place to make sure that these patients now who are already operated were taken care of. But we hope that the government will handle the grievances from these allied health professionals and the nurses so that they are more motivated to work smoothly and not affect the plans for the hospital so that we can achieve a higher output and care for all the patients as we planned.
Story by Shamshad Naluja for the news.